All right, so let's work on a simple if statement. So the idea here is just to test some condition to see if it's true or false. So we're going to start out with a little bit of code here. Let's just go ahead and put in a simple user input statement, right? So we can see here we're just asking for a number, converting it to an integer. And as long as we're at it there, we probably want to go ahead and put in our comments there so we can see what it does. You can see we're displaying a message on the screen. All right, the next thing we want to do is we want to test a variable, right? So let's go ahead and kind of comment this out, sort of see what I want to do. I want to test a variable to determine if it's larger than 5, all right? So anytime I'm asking a question, right, that's an if statement. So let's go ahead and think about this. So if we want to determine if user number is larger than 5, so quite simply we'll say if user number is greater than 5. Now remember, whenever we do if statements, we have to start code block for anything that'll happen inside that statement. So that's always the colon. So anything after the colon that needs to run would need to be indented. Now the nice thing is most of our software will indent automatically for us. So you can see it's already put us in there. So what's going to happen if it's greater than 5? Well, I think in this case what I'm going to want to do is do like a user-friendly message. So let's go ahead and drop in a comment here to say I want to do a user-friendly message. And I think that message will just simply be print the number. The number is more than 5. Right. So we can see here, we can check this by saying, will it let us put in a number, and we'll check that number. So let's go ahead and save this as a Python file here. And just put it anywhere here. And we'll go ahead and run it. And we'll see here it asks for a number. So if I put in, oops, gotta click on that first, put in a 10, it's gonna say, yeah, 10 is more than 5. Now I'd obviously wanna test that to make sure that it's working. Let's clear that and do it again here. See if I put in a 4. Nothing happens. And that's expected, right? Because I can see here, that if it's not greater than 5, there's going to be nothing that happens. I probably want to add something in here just to say nothing's going to happen. So probably some sort of finishing statement. So let's maybe a comment here, display it finished, and we'll just say print finished. And if we run it now, we can take a look, enter a whole number. If I put in something less than 5, I can say, nothing happened, and it's finished. So this is an example of a simple if statement. A lot of times we'll use these as ways to validate information. So, you know, if number is greater than 5, add 1 to my count, right? That sort of thing. Just really simple statements where we want to check something. If it's true, we want something to happen. If it's not true, we just want to move on with our program.